Balancing regulation and resilience. The first step is thinking about our nervous systems. So my perspective is all about how our body processes stress. And when we think about it, often it's just in the individual. When I have stress, the sympathetic response comes in and prepares me to fight, flee, or shut down as needed. And after that threat is over, then there's settling that happens, supposedly, right? In somebody who has developmental trauma, the issue is that that process never really got developed in a really clear way on the settling side. So it's like their system literally doesn't know how to come out of the stress response. So they may come down a little bit, but it's never a really regulated, present, engaged kind of place, okay? So that's what my work is designed to do, is to help the system be able to learn how to regulate itself. So it's different from like when, you know, the teachers at the school will say, your child needs to self-regulate. What they mean is, they need to not blurt out the answer. They need to be able to stand in line with the other children. Those kinds of things. Like, they need to regulate their behavior. But that's an external experience. I'm talking about the internal experience of being able to process stress. So when that isn't happening, it's just getting backlogged until it overflows, or they shut down, or they have a meltdown, or whatever it is, because it's just trickling through. The bandwidth on the filter is just too small. And so our job is to teach the system how to work and to expand the bandwidth.